Good morning, everyone. And welcome as we gather for the Coventry Litany of Reconciliation today. Today is a significant day for our partners in the community of the Cross of Nails around the world because tomorrow will be the 80th anniversary of the blitzing of Coventry and the destruction of Coventry Cathedral. We gather here today as we do with partners around the world to offer the prayer. Today at noon in the United Kingdom, in Coventry, and in various other places in Europe, the Coventry prayer was offered tonight at 7 o'clock. There's a link which I put on my Facebook page to a special event that's happening in Coventry, 7 o'clock Coventry time, so probably earlier here, I would think. So 2 o'clock in the afternoon here. So you can tune in to watch that, and I'm sure that will be recorded as well. The operation that launched the Blitz of Coventry had the horribly ironic name of Moonlight Sonata. It's the irony of this. When we gather together and we offer prayer, we pray to heal the wounds of history. We look to build a culture of peace based on inclusion and tolerance. That's the beauty of what we offer, but it is always in the face of the hardship and difficulty of the evil that people will perpetrate one against another. But when we gather, we proclaim here and with our partners around the world that that kind of darkness and hatred never has the last word. That we rise up the next day, we lift up our drooping arms, and we proclaim the message of hope and justice and peace, both at home and around the world. And that's why it is so important for us to mark an anniversary like this. These nails, I brought our Cross of Nails out to be here with us today. These nails were part of a smoldering ruin 80 years ago. But out of those ashes of the wastes of our wraths and sorrows, something beautiful rose again. And that's what we proclaim in our faith. It's the heart of our Christian faith. We proclaim the life and the death of Jesus Christ, but we proclaim resurrection, new life, and hope. And so when we gather here today in this place and offer this prayer, that's the heart, that's the center, that's the focus of everything that we do. Blessings on you for coming here today to make your stand here in this place. These are challenging times for us as we hear the news of what's happening with COVID-19 around our province, and the numbers that are coming out and the concerns are beginning to escalate beyond what we have seen so far. And that's going to put stress on our communities and stress on our society, stress on our families, stress on our relationships. And so people committed to the cause of reconciliation have a lot of work to do over these days. So let's take a few moments as we await the noon bells to ring and offer our litany prayer with our partners around the world on this very auspicious day. For Provost Richard Howard put the words, "Father, forgive," on the wall behind the charred cross and the ruins of the destroyed cathedral in 1948. Not, "Father, forgive them, because we have all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God." These words move generations of people and are prayed in the Litany of Reconciliation every Friday at noon, outside in the ruins of Coventry and on many other places around the world. The Litany of Reconciliation, based on the seven cardinal sins, was written in 1958 by Canon Joseph Poole, the first precentor of the new cathedral. It is a universal and timeless confession of humanity's failings, but it evokes us to approach these sins and weaknesses in the forgiveness of God's love. And so in silence, let us pray. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. The hatred which divides nation from nation, race from race, class from class. The covetous desires of people and nations to possess what is not their own. The greed which exploits the work of human hands and lays waste the earth. Our envy of the welfare and happiness of others. Our indifference to the plight of the imprisoned, the homeless, the refugee. The lust which dishonors the bodies of men, women, and children. The pride which leads us to trust in ourselves and not in God. Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another as God in Christ forgave you. Amen. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Blessings, everyone. Have a wonderful week ahead. Look forward to being here with you next week. So this isn't too bad for mid-November. Take care, everyone.